Are we ready? I hear some excitement here. You're like, no, not. But it's okay. So, this is going to be fun. I am excited for this experience. So let me go over a few things real quick. Just like before, if you guys could log into Canvas, and once you guys log in Canvas, get this presentation, because this presentation has some of the links. Also, what I need you guys to do if you're just coming in, I need you guys to find a 3D printer. There are 7 around here. So find a 3D printer and hang out there. Hopefully you guys all set up the Tinkercad account. If not, it's okay. I still like you guys. Why don't we go on? Because I want to make sure we get our time going. So first, raise your hand if you're listening to me, because I'm not sure. Okay, that's about half of you. This is good. So let me kind of set up the stage here. We have an audacious goal to get 60 plus people who have not learned how to 3D print before to 3D prints. And I thought to myself, how are we ever going to do this? This is crazy. Cray cray, as a lot of high schoolers would say. But something I learned when I went to this training back in December is after an hour, I knew how to use basic AutoCAD, which is the drawing component of 3D printing. The second hour, I was able to print. So that's our goal. Within the next 2 hours, you guys should be able to 3D print on your own and know how to use a 3D printer, which is kind of exciting. What's crazy, because I needed to learn how to use a 3D printer, I actually brought one home. Don't tell the district. And I told my kids, two of them, you could go crazy and design stuff and I'll print it, because I need to figure out how to use it. And what's crazy is, they were designing chess pieces, they were designing Quidditch sets, and they were designing this, that, and the other thing on their iPads, and we were able to print it. And they were doing this in minutes. So I would like to really encourage you to open your mind to some of the possibilities, because there's a lot of things to do with this equipment. So, again, Tinkercad.com, if you don't have this, it's going to slow you down. Do, if your work email doesn't work, do it through your personal email. Tinkercad.com. So, what I wanted to get into, why is this not working? There we go. Before we go on, I just kind of want to go over a quick reflection. Yesterday we had Ed Hidalgo, and you guys had some time to work together. And just really, really quickly, I wanted to ask you guys to talk in your groups right now about something that you guys gained from yesterday, some reflections that you guys had. So in your groups, if you don't know everybody, introduce yourselves to everybody. Say your name, who you are, and just one thing you guys gained from yesterday, if you were to. You guys ready? So, introduce yourself, and one thing you gained from yesterday, go.
You're never going to get a bag.
I know. Oh, one thought for
you. Oh, my God. The mail is being dropped off the mail. I can do that, right?
Yeah. Oh, man. I don't know if you do.
I'm sorry.
now that we've decided, well, this is working. I like this.
Ah, voy a abrir porque siempre está bien. Ah, sí.
Focus on our students' training, in turn, make them more successful in their lives and their relationships.
How about over here? Anybody, any reflections from yesterday?
We really like Civ and career choices, and it was very eye-opening.
Great, bad, everything. You guys are going to learn how to install the filament, how to take it out, so that you're feeling more comfortable with that. The calibration and leveling piece is really important, because if you don't know how to calibrate, your print job may not turn out okay. And also basic maintenance and cleaning. Each of these 3D printers have a little thing that you have to do, like for the XYZ printer, which are the bigger printers. After you print, I found it very effective to clean off the nozzle every single time. For the Dremel printers, I heard from some people that sometimes you have to level it before every use. So there's a little few tricks in the trade that will help you. And then ideally, there's already a sample printed for each of you guys, but we're gonna try to print another small sample that shouldn't take too long, just so you guys could see it from start to finish. You guys ready? So if I could have the leads, I'm gonna give you a total of about 30 minutes. And if it's too long, that's fine. But I really want you to go, you know, in depth, open up the hood, take out the filament, take out the print, and just go through that process so that every single person knows how to use this printer. You guys got it? You guys good? Okay, so this is, you need no computers. You guys get to get your hands dirty and take a tour. I'm gonna set a timer. If you guys have things to work on, please go to work on them here for as long as you want. I will be here for a while cleaning up. Number two, as you guys are cleaning up, could you make sure that you guys get as much stuff cleaned up as you guys can? For the people who brought 3D printers, I can help you load the 3D printers into your car. And is there anything else? I think that's it. All I can say is you guys rock. Thank you guys for all your hard work. If you guys are still working, great work. Otherwise, clean up and you guys are good to go. Have a great week. Oh, thank you. Oh, last one. Ben, you're a rock star. Please, please, please. The only way this could get better is by giving feedback. So at the very end, please make sure you do the reflection at the end. The reflection is that same thing that you did yesterday. What is it? It's S right over here, tinyurl.com, SUHSD workshop feedback. And after you guys do that, you're good to go. Any questions? Thoughts? You guys good? Oh, wait. I think we're good. All right, we're good. As you guys start heading back to your seat, I want to highlight a few things.
Yeah, my son used to see that.
So,
and now he's like, yeah, whatever you guys want.
Who's ready to buy a 3D printer for your house? But I was really tempted over a break. They actually have the XYZ Mini, which is kind of about this big. It's the size of a regular printer that you can get for about $300 on Amazon. It actually might even be $289. And it was very, very, very tempted to get it because it just looked like a lot of fun. But my wife advised me against it. So this, I want to kind of take a little step back. We actually started this process today with tinkering with 3D printing at 8:30. Raise up your hand if you had any experience 3D printing or using CAD software before that. So we have 1, 2, 3, and also the leads who had 3D printing kind of experience. And now it is 10:45. And by 10:45, I hope a majority of you at least feel that you have a sense of how the TinkerCAD software works, which is kind of a simpler version. Another one's called 123 Design, which is also a good, simple version. And if you feel that you could walk your way through that, that is a win. And then the next stage of that was being able to print your designs. I know some people are still in the process of printing, but raise up your hand if you're at least able to try printing some of your designs today. Some of them, and people are in the process of. I think that's great. And these 3D printers are going to be here the rest of today. So if you guys come up with something you want to design throughout the rest of the day, go to town. Because as long as you start the print job by 1:30, 2 o'clock, your print job will be printed out and done before you leave today so you can take it home. So I want to encourage you. These are your printers to play with until the end of today. And then if you guys want 3D printers at your school site, a lot of you have them at your school site, and we have 2 to loan out. Okay? So we're now going to go on to the next phase. I want to show you some resources here. Now, you do not necessarily have to come up with everything from scratch with how to 3D print your classroom, because one, that would really be difficult, because none of us are 3D printing experts. So here's what's already available. On our Google page, and on this PowerPoint, you have Dremel 3D printing lesson plans. This is on the ESP Google site, and what's cool about these lesson plans is it gives you example STL files, as well as lesson plans that show you how to use it. So if I wanted to go to topography, if I wanted to do something about, you know, the rise of sea levels, I could go into here and I could actually get some of the lesson plans of how to do topographical maps using 3D printing. They also have all of these for the windmill lab. They have their own windmill lab. They have their own propeller boat lab. They have other labs that are already created aligned with Common Core and NGS standards for you, which I think is pretty awesome. So this is one of the reasons why, as a district, we decided to go with Dremel, because things are already there and aligned. So when we break up into our POC groups, I'm going to encourage you just to peruse through these, because it will go through the lesson plans. It will also go through some of the files that you could literally just print right then and there. So it goes through these steps by steps. If you go through another one, I thought what was cool is when I was looking through the another Dremel lesson plan, it was the propellers or the water filter, which is also another cool one. But there's a lot of cool things that you guys could build. The wind power, and actually you could look at some of the assembled windmill that they created with the 3D printing. So again, you don't have to come up with them all on your own. A lot of it's already there. So the other question is, what if it's not there? What if you have another idea? What else can you do? Now, I'm going to challenge somebody. There is another website called Thingiverse. It is the coolest website out there when it comes to 3D printing. Can I have... Let's see, how about Melissa? Name any object you can think of. G-rated, please.
Danielle.
No pressure. Or anybody, yell it out. What was it?
Gear.
Up here?
Gear.
Ear?
Gear.
Oh, gear. So if I type in gear, and say I don't want to build a gear myself, say I want to just find a gear. I type in gear. And what I have is all of these different types of gears already made for you. So if I was doing a pulley lab in physics, or a gear lab in physics, I could just type in gear, and I could just search around for the type of gears I want. This one gives me a whole different set of gears. I click on that, I get it as an STL file, and I literally just hit print. And I will have all the gears ready for the lab that I want. So it's another pretty cool thing. Say I wanted to do DNA for biology. If I wanted DNA, type in DNA. And then you have your DNA model that you could print out and manipulate for your classroom. Anything that you could think of that can be built has probably already been built for you. So that's kind of a cool way to think of it. Now another cool thing that you could do, Because again, you don't have to think about how to do all of this on your own. Say you wanted to do an activity, but you wanted step-by-step instructions, and you didn't want to create it. Then we have YouTube. And say in Tinkercad, I wanted to figure out how to build a boat. So what I could do is type in Tinkercad. Oh,
not this transmission.
And when I do that, oh my goodness. There are automatic step-by-step instructions in YouTube that you can show your students so that they know how to build a boat step-by-step using Tinkercad. Or 1-2-3 design or whatever software you need. So what I'm telling you is, you don't have to think. I mean, you have to do a little bit, I'm just kidding. But you have to design all this stuff because it's there for you. Another thing that George put in on this link.
Okay, so Autodesk has created the AutoCAD file, and for years they've been known as the authority in 3D design software, used by most professionals. So they created this site called Ignite, and they've loaded it with lots of projects that are also aligned with standards that you can use for free. It's cloud-based, and it walks you through and your students how to use them. So let's take a quick peek. Let's go up here to projects.
Add a face to Mount Rushmore.
You click 3D Design Electronics. We're going to go to 3D Design. Who wants to do this project? That actually involves circuits, Arduino, which you can see with this little icon here. But you could also 3D print some parts. The ones that have this logo are 100% designed. You don't need anything else. There's actually a project in here called Let's Learn 3D Together, and it walks you through Tinkercad in a way that your students can learn it with you for the first time. Balloon-powered car. We have something like that. We have a lesson plan for that. So let's click on one of these.
BB-8
Here's the objectives, the description.
These are all just silly.
Step-by-step with Tinkercad. Again, when you start the lesson, it walks you through. So all their students can jump on, sign up, make their own accounts, and then they can go through step-by-step with you. So just another resource that's out there with lots of what to do with that new printer you have. Standards that you had to teach anyway, like Common Core and GSS. Sorry, you could bring those ideas to life through prototyping, but the most important part is when students learn from their mistakes, when they're trying to accomplish something and then they design it in a program like Tinkercad, and then it doesn't work, it snaps, it's too small, it fails, the gears don't line up, they're learning from that. And they go back and they fix it. And from those mistakes, they're actually getting better at what they're doing. They're also learning these soft skills here, the four C's: collaboration, communication, creativity, critical thinking. You could add to that problem-based learning. So here's an example of one of our projects, which is design a propeller boat that can go across a planter bed full with water. So they work in teams, right? A typical classroom of 30 students would work into 5 or 6 teams. They would design the propeller. They would design the boat. They would print it. They would test it and see if they can get across in the desired time. If it doesn't, then they have to refine it. Maybe they made the boat too big or too small or too deep or too tall. Maybe it tipped over. Maybe the propeller wasn't good enough, but as they redesign it and they learn, that's where they're getting their true learnings from that iterative process. And along the way, they're picking up these skills. Now, moreover, we just saw that video. We know that biomedical companies are starting to invest in 3D. General Electric, GE, Boeing, many of these manufacturers are also now printing their own parts. So these skills that are going to be needed in the labor force are also being developed. Once you understand how to do things in three dimensions, and you know how to go from concept to a finished product, you have a pretty bright career with many of these companies that are moving towards not manufacturing in China, but doing one-offs here, but don't have the skill force to hire to do those jobs. So it's not just the collaborative learning and critical thinking, it's also building real skills that they can take to the next level. Anthony?
Yes. So, you know, what George said, which I thought was really cool, is this grant, again, is an engineering grant. The important part of the whole 3D printing process is the actual development of the 3D print model. You know, it's going to take some practice for the students. And sometimes we'll be able to just print a few models for demonstration, but there are going to be some times where they can actually design and build. So I want to highlight a few things. Carrie Northam showed you some of these examples that were based off of some of your lesson plans for GS1. There are lesson plans already for a filtration system for water or crystal pits, so you could actually pick out. For GS2, you guys are doing a lot with astronomy, and you could actually find lesson plans for how to build shield prototypes, or you could actually print models of craters that are out there. For biology, printing parts of the heart, printing parts of the cell membrane. Whatever you guys can imagine, what's really cool is YouTube is powerful. If you don't know how to do something, you could just go to YouTube and they'll teach you how to do it step by step. Or if you're like, I'm too lazy, I just wanted to print it, you could find the actual file. I'll show you how to do that. For chemistry, there's so many different parts of chemistry that are hard to visualize, but you can actually build something so that you can actually feel it and see it. So, and for physics, there's so much fun stuff for physics. From the boat, the propeller project, there's a lot of different things. Prosthetic arm projects, egg drop designs, helmet designs that you can do with 3D printing. So, what I want to show you is, here are the schools that actually have 3D printers. Cass Park Middle, Cass Park High, Chula Vista, the district office, Bonita Vista Middle, Hilltop High Middle, Mar Vista, Academy and High School, Montgomery Middle, Rancho Del Rey, San Isidro, Southwest, Sweetwater. Now, if I did not call out your name, it's okay because, again, as I said, we have two extra 3D printers that we can bring to your school site. And there are also some schools that have 3D printers that are not listed here. Okay? So, here's what we're going to do. Enough talking. We're actually going to do a few things.
Yeah, my school was not listed.
This is the time that you guys get to familiarize yourself with the printer. So there is a lead at each of the tables. And as a lead, they're going to be doing the following with you guys. So you actually feel, touch, and mess with the printer. One, you are going to learn the basic parts of the printer, from the filament to the extruder to the print bed, everything. You guys are going to learn how to install the filament, how to take it out, so that you're feeling more comfortable with that. The calibration and leveling piece is really important, because if you don't know how to calibrate, your print job may not turn out okay. And also basic maintenance and cleaning. Each of these 3D printers have a little thing that you have to do, like for the XYZ printer, which are the bigger printers. After you print, I found it very effective to clean off the nozzle every single time. For the drum printers, I heard from some people that sometimes you have to level it before every use. So there's a little few tricks of the trade that will help you. And then ideally, there's already a sample printed for each of you guys, but we're going to try to print another small sample that shouldn't take too long, just so you guys can see it from start to finish. You guys ready? So if I could have the leads, I'm going to give you a total of about 30 minutes. And if it's too long, that's fine. But I really want you to go, you know, in depth, open up the hood, take out the filament, take out the thread, and just go through that process so that every single person knows how to use the printer. You guys got it? You guys good? Okay, so this is, you need no computers. You guys get to get your hands dirty and take a tour.
Yeah, and at first I just need to have the color. So I probably just need to come back.
Oh, that's right. I'm trying to organize this like cotton dye, but I got a whole bag of right now. You've got folded to it. So I'm looking at the great thing.
Maybe I'll come to your field soon. Right. You're not sunny, so you're close to your home. You know, sometimes I think about talking to Mr. and say, can I just excuse myself?
I have a picture to look.
Oh yeah, I saw that. Yeah, if you guys want to make one? Are you just going to give us one? We didn't order enough for everybody to get one.
Yeah, we took one yesterday.
Did you give one to them? You didn't give anything to them. We didn't take anything.
There were 8 to 10.
Unless Ryan took something.
How much is a roll?
This roll is $35, approximately. So they said it gives you about 22 hours of printing. So this puzzle piece took like 30 minutes.
But what if you wanted to change colors?
One of the things with this 3D printer, because they're on the cheaper side, is if you wanted to have a piece that was multicolor, you could stop it, change the filament out, and then it'll pick it back up where you stopped. If you get to the more expensive 3D printers, it will have two extruders, where you're gonna have two different ones, so you can actually seamlessly pick what's gonna be what color, yeah, okay. Without that.
Is that as many as you get? Like, if you can go up to like even more?
I have not looked into that because even two is really expensive.
Yeah, for what we can afford.
For what we can afford. So I'm like, why
do one color at a time?
Yes.
Do you have other colors than white?
I didn't bring the other colors. We have like orange, black. I mean, pretty much you can get any color.
You have blue?
Oh, we do have a blue, too.
Smart blue, exactly.
Blue and white?
Red?
Yeah,
but exactly. White is so common, I figured I'd want to use that one first. So, when you're loading it, the filament, you want to make sure that you're loading it from the bottom, because it'll automatically spin as it's being pulled through.
So you just put the whole roll in.
So there's a lead tube right here, and you just push it through. And then that lead stops up here. You might have to stand up for that. So the tube goes from here to here. And then you're going to feed it right through this guider. And this just helps keep it in place. And if you get a different 3D printer, like I have a MakerBot, the lead goes from here all the way to the extruder.
So you just keep pushing.
So you'll get it through here. Yeah, I can. Do you want me to cut it? And
I would say go for it.
Then we're wasting plastic.
So does that mean that when you get to the end, you can't use this small little piece to feed it through?
So when you get to the end of the roll, it'll pull it through and it'll use it. And then once it's out of filament, it'll stop the print.
So if you, like you said, cut it. So if you've got a piece that's like this, it just has to fit as far as that.
It just has to get into this part, yes.
Then
it's
not worth
it. It's not worth it. But, I mean, a piece that small is not going to do much. Because what happens, and we'll do another print, is...
We'll cut it down here so you have a piece that you can use.
No. You would cut it right here to change the filament.
Oh, to change it.
Yeah. The only reason why you would cut it would be to change the filament.
Oh, I see. And that's why the piece would go into this one.
Yes. If you would like me to cut it,
yeah, let's see.
I will.
Oh, so that happened.
Say that again? About $30.
And that is specifically what this one uses. That
yes.
It doesn't use any other type of material.
So, there's two types of filaments. But what Dremel has done, they've made this area smaller. So the MakerBot has a bigger roll, and it's actually more cost effective. But it doesn't fit in this area.
I don't know if this is the same question, but you've got this plastic in there. You've got metal or any other kind of...
It's only plastic.
Only plastic.
Because it's a hard plastic. So this is actually, every time there's a print, it'll do a test strip to make sure it's at the right temperature. So that's the test strip. Some will go all the way across, it just depends on the size. But usually it's at least this much to make sure that it's going to be consistent, and then it'll actually start to print.
So each printer uses its own specific materials. Because like I saw in the video that it also said concrete. So you can actually have 3D concrete.
Yes, but those are really large.
And they're super expensive.
Yeah, sure. Yeah, there are two different types you heard about. I heard about two different types of plastics, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
PLA and...
Those are just specific to whatever.
Exactly. Well, no, you can have those two. You can use as long as the diameter is the correct size.
Okay.
One's wire soluble, one's not.
Right.
Okay. And so it's just a cost.
So this one is water soluble.
Yes.
So if we put in the water, we're gonna have nothing left.
It'll take quite some time to do that.
Like many weeks, months?
I would say weeks.
So that way, if you put that in water, it will go away.
It'll break down, it'll become soft.
Okay. So these are the things we don't want to get wet. And you have...
If they get slightly wet, you're fine. It's just right. Sitting in it.
I like the boat. You don't want to make the boat.
You don't want to drop an aquarium.
The boats would work. It's just if you left them in there for a very long period of time. So what we have, you're going to have to stand up to see this. When you're loading it, and sometimes there's a little lever here. This lever is spring activated. So when you're loading it in, and I'll show you up here in the front. When you go to load, so here's the little lever. That actually opens it up to feed the filament in. And then you let it go, then it grabs, because there's gears that are pulling it down. Sometimes, if it's not going in, all you need to do is pull this down to kind of open up the space. It could be because there's a slight jam.
Can you do that for us?
I could do this. Sure. Let's just go through the entire thing. I can see that.
So once it's all the way in like that, you can't just pull it out?
You technically could, but...
Like if you push down the spring,
it's set in.
Oh, because it's already made something.
It's already down there.
Yeah.
So, what we can do, I don't know if you might have to come over here now.
So while we're waiting, this is the scraper. This is probably the best way to get your print objects off. It takes a little force, because when the plastic is put on there, it creates a nice little suction on there. And you'll notice the more and more you print, the suction will decrease because the surface isn't as sticky. So this is better than using a metal spatula because or a flathead screwdriver, which I have to use on my other one, because when you use the flathead, sometimes you dig into the tape. So if we're going to change the filament,
you have to turn it on first.
Yes, because it's gonna have to heat up. So if you're looking here on the screen, you have. Well, let's just go. We'll go through the screen. You have your build options. So you have a USB right here, where you can you'll load your items onto the USB, or you can plug it into a laptop and transfer that way. There are some pre-loaded items. So you have the frog, a bear, chess pieces.
Are there snowflakes in there? Because some of our students just
snowflakes are not in here. Oh,
okay.
Those can be found on Thingiverse, where some of them are free, others are you have to pay for the design. So there are some preloaded. So then the filament. So it says cut the. The great thing about this is the directions are right there. First thing you want to do, cut the filament. So we'll cut. Okay. So you cut it. Goes next. Now what it's gonna do? It's gonna heat it all up, and it's gonna extrude the remaining filament.
And since it's just such a small amount, it doesn't really make sense. You could make a button.
No, it'll just heat it up, take it straight down.
Okay. So there isn't anything.
There's nothing you can use it for. You could cut it on this side if you want to save an inch of plastic.
And so how far is it into this? Oh, I guess down to where the track is.
So the extruder is on the bottom. It's this metal little knob all on the bottom there.
Okay, I see it.
So it's directly under there. Once it heats up, it'll start melting all the plastic.
So how many objects do you think you'd make? How many little chess pieces with that stuff?
I think you can make definitely one side. So as you
not with that, but I mean with your whole roll.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't know.
A whole chess set?
Probably. You can get a whole chess set.
I think Lauren said like 50 pieces at least.
Yeah, but I mean that's like really arbitrary because we don't know how big a piece is. You mean pieces of chess?
Of that size.
So
I think she said like 100.
Is her roll the same size?
Yeah, about.
So when it comes out,
if you guys finish early,
yeah.
You guys can go on to the next step, which is
so it's not hot.
Just whatever your group is ready. So the whole point of the Tinkercad chip clip is to get you familiar with Tinkercad. Okay. There is, once you're logging into Tinkercad, there is a YouTube video on the on PowerPoint that goes over how to.
Really, that's bigger. Caitlin, now you're going to level it.
I'm
sorry. Right now, you know more than me.
So see how it's not leveled? It says the build platform is too high. So there's little knobs on the bottom of it, and it tells you turn left to lower it, and even to the arrow. You're gonna turn it, and so you keep going until you get 18 seconds. Oh, yeah. Just keep going until it gives you a green check mark. There you go. And now click verify. I'm going to test it again.
so easy. You have to keep it close, which it doesn't matter. So it's a little still too high, so turn left again to layer. So again, a little bit green there.
Still going?
Test it again.
Two level.
Two level, because you get excited. You build something, you want to like print it right away.
So the information will get to your dashboard?
Yes.
Where did that go? Oh, right there.
Okay.
So,
yeah.
Yeah.
So you're going to, if you want to start building, YouTube bag chip Tinkercad bag chip, and then it'll give you all the stuff to build within Tinkercad. So you're going to be following the video.
So there's a lead tube right here, and you just push it through, and then that lead stops up here. You might have to stand up for that. The tube goes from here through here, and then you're going to feed it right through this guider, and this just helps keep it in place. And if you get a different 3D printer, like I have a MakerBot, the lead goes from here all the way to the extruder piece.
So you just keep pushing, so you, until
you'll,
it comes out.
You'll get it through here. Yeah, I can, do you want me to cut it and
go for it.
Then we're wasting plastic.
So does that mean that when you get to the end, you can't use a small little piece to feed it through?
So when you get to the end of the roll, it'll pull it through and it'll use it. And then once it's out of filament, it'll stop the print.
So if, like you said, cut it. So if you've got a piece that's like this, it just has to fit as far as that.
It just has to get into this part.
And
yes.
Then you can.
Yeah.
It's not a waste.
It's not a waste.
Okay.
But I mean, a piece that small is not going to do much. Because what happens, and we'll do another print, is
we'll cut it down here so you have a piece that you can use.
No. You would cut it right here to change the filament.
To change the filament.
Yeah. The only reason why you would cut it would be to change the filament.
Oh, I see, and that's why the piece would bully you this long.
Yes. If you would like me to cut it,
I will.
Say that again? About $30.
And that is specifically what this one uses.
Yes.
Doesn't use any other type of material.
So there's two types of filaments. But what Dremel has done, they've made this area smaller. So the MakerBot has a bigger roll, and it's actually more cost effective, but it doesn't fit in this area.
And then, so, I don't know if this is the same question, but you've got this plastic in there. You've got metal or any other kind in there?
It's only plastic.
Only plastic.
Because it's a hard plastic. So this is actually, every time there's a print, it'll do a test strip to make sure it's at the right temperature. So that's the test strip. Some will go all the way across, it just depends on the size. But usually it's at least this much to make sure that it's a good consistency, and then it'll actually start to print.
And so each printer uses its own specific materials. Because like I saw in the video that it also said concrete. So you can actually have a 3D concrete.
Yes, but those are really large.
And they're super expensive.
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, there are two different types we heard about, or I heard about. Two different types of plastics, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
PLA and
those would just be specific to whatever.
Exactly. Well, no, you can add those two. You can use as long as the diameter is the correct size.
Okay.
One's water soluble, one's not.
Right.
Okay.
And so it's just a cost.
So this one is water soluble.
Yes.
So if we put it in water, we're gonna have nothing left.
It would take quite some time to do that.
Like meaning weeks, months.
I would say weeks.
So that if you put that in water, it would go away.
It'll break down. It'll become soft.
A blank layout surface.
you can drag and add and resize things to that surface. Yeah. And then you tell it, you know, print all this stuff at one time.
It's also in Gingerbread?
No, that's the printer software, which is called Print Studio. Yes.
You have to download that?
Yeah. And you can download it onto the And so, with the Print Studio, basically what that's telling it is what each layer looks like, right? Like the three-dimensional object, imagine cutting it out of the Xerox papers. So, the print software is telling it what each slice is as a separate file. Which is kind of an interesting concept.
4 weeks at the
No, it's printing it out. Let me use the scientific one that my children will use, right? So it's telling it, you know, layer one is a circle. Making topographic maps out of cardboard, but you know what I'm talking about, right? It's basically the same idea, except it's each layer is much, much thinner.
During the construction of a given form, can you stop the machine and fill in another color?
You can tell it to change color.
So I had them do
it. Well, it would be a beautiful design.
Is the chip clip on the left?
Yeah. It's supposed to have an opening.
Translate.
But these still might be the supports.
HCL.
Oh, yeah.
MGCL, too.
You see how it's like, when it went back and forth, it's like really small?
Maybe, yeah. There's hope.
Oh, yeah. MGCL.
Right.
Two greens on both sides. Yeah.
It brought it all together.
Yeah, I think it did. Because even how it's filling in those letters,
like the actual letters are smaller than the
activity. I can't because it's all for copyright.
Oh, okay.
But it was, it's this. It's
I wonder how much time would it save putting them closer together? Just only because, so like, every time it does that adds up.
It's, yeah, what's right. his name? Bonding by James. Bond by, yeah, bond, the bond together, with James.
So you really can put.
And it's
12 main
reaction types.
Oh, that size? Mm-hmm. Wow.
I think it was all part of his
But I guess one mistake would compound.
Because all of this.
So, like, let's say it got a clog somewhere here, yeah. Then yeah. Everything else would be good.
This is. It's a worthwhile little thing that he makes something.
Oh, and the end on your controller, the nitrogen that was messed up, it looks like that was still part of the base. Because if you look at.
Oh, really?